Rolly, who do you think that was?
This is my man, Tim Bradley.
He's from South Africa.
Yes, yeah.
My cousin lives in South Africa. He got married.
He got married to
He moved over there and got married to a South African.
South African.
Yeah. I never been there.
He thought you were Tim Bradley.
Oh, you thought I'm not the first, right?
Everybody says that, huh? You hear that a lot. You, Tim Bradley.
It's the forehead.
Oh, thanks. He wants a picture with you, Rolly. Hey, O'Hara Davis is in the little restaurant. Nah, let him go. Let him go, Rolly. Yeah. So first of all, I wake up early every day. I go on my social media and I see Ryan Garcia saying, I'm fighting Rolly next. I told my team to get that fight. So you posted a poster of you and him. Tell me about the feeling. How do you feel right now that you might fight Ryan next? It looks like it.
I'm very feel.
Were you surprised? Excited?
I'm very feel right now.
It's a big fight, Rolly. It's a big pay-per-view fight. The fans are into it. Everyone's excited. You sparred Ryan. You're a trash talker. He's one of the biggest names in sports. It's a big deal.
Yeah, very big deal.
So what do you tell people when they ask you about it?
Very big deal. Very big deal.
You obviously, no negotiations have started yet, right? But you look slim. You look ready to, you look in shape. You look ready to go.
Yeah, you're the first person to say that.
Hey, does he look in shape? Does he look skinny? You look good. What do you think about him and Ryan? Do you like the fight? Do you like the pelea? Muy bien?
Yeah.
Bonita? Bonito?
Beautiful.
Beautiful fight. What does he need to do in that fight?
I don't know. We're going to wait until that happens.
You have power. He has power. You sparred him. Anything that you can take from the sparring that can help you on fight night?
Everything.
I wanted to ask you, tonight I saw you on TV, Barroso knocked out O'Hara Davis in 5 punches. So I was with Virgil Ortiz and seemed in the locker room, and I said, you gotta give Rolly credit. Because everything he hit you with, you took it.
Man, that motherfucker can cry.
Yep.
Y'all thought I was joking, and on top of that, I got him on TV. And I literally told everybody before the fight, now, at the press conference, and I was like, y'all confused, this dude can punch, this dude's way better than Pueyo, this dude, like, this ain't no easy fight, this dude is difficult.
Yep.
This is a real fighter. You don't get 25-0 with, 25 wins with 23 knockouts unless you're not a damn puncher.
No, he's a huge puncher, and we saw it tonight. Now, O'Hara was talking a lot of trash. Did you talk to him after the fight at all?
No.
You just let it go?
I just haven't seen him.
But he, obviously... now Barroso won a title tonight, so you're the main champion at 140 and he's like the, what's it called, interim. So you and Ryan for the title, is that the idea?
We shall see.
Any comment from anyone? Did you get any calls today? Anybody reach out to you?
I got a lot of phone calls today. Yeah.
What did the fans tell you tonight, Rolly?
They didn't really tell me much. They just love me, you know.
No, you do get a lot of love at the fights.
They just appreciate the fact that I'm here and you know, showing them love as well, you know, because if they show me love, I show them love, you know.
How sick will the lead-in be to the fight with you and Ryan, the press conferences, and are you excited about that? You like that, Roman.
Like I said, we shall see.
So you're just waiting until it's official, but it's in the right direction, obviously. So what do you tell Ryan if he's watching?
We shall see.
Okay. What do you think about him hanging out with Floyd? You know Floyd very well. You've been on the road with Floyd, if I'm not mistaken. You went with him to the Middle East and Europe, right?
It's good. He should be around a champion.
Why is it good?
Because being influenced or being around great fighters makes you a great fighter.
What do you say if people say, hey, the reason you're getting the fight is because Floyd told him?
Wasn't he the one that called me out after he fought?
He did call you out after he fought. So that's it. But you enjoyed the fight tonight? Virgil Ortiz, I wish they gave him another 10 seconds, but it is what it is.
Virgil's a Gregory Ortiz is a monster.
20-0, 20 knockouts.
He is a fucking monster. And I'm happy to see him back because he's been away from the sport for 2 months.
17 months and 3 fights canceled and health stuff.
Yeah.
He's a good kid too, yeah, very polite.
Good kid, I heard a lot. He need to learn how to speak Spanish. Cause he looked like he should know how to speak
okay.
Spanish.
Barroso against Teal, who wins?
I'm going with my man Barroso.
Barroso and Haney, who wins?
I'm going with my man Barroso.
Why? Why do you pick him in those fights?
Cause I said so.
I just interviewed Barroso and I said, what did Rolly tell you? And he said, Rolly told me good fight. Did you tell when you jumped up in the apron? I'm surprised security didn't rush you, Rolly.
I ain't gonna rush me. I'm rolling.
No, I know. I know, but I'm surprised because usually they don't let people on the apron. But what did you tell him?
I just told him, congratulations, and you're a real champ. I was like, I knew this shit was gonna happen.
And what did he tell you?
And he was just happy. He was just happy.
He's a very nice person, by the way. I got to know him a little bit. Very religious.
Yeah, very
humble.
Religious. He believes in God. I'm telling you, that's his strength right there.
Yeah, you told me. I asked him where he gets the strength. He said, from God. He's just a believer.
That's his strength right there.
And he's not that old in person. I don't know why, but in the pictures and videos, Rolly, it adds 10 years. In person, he doesn't look that old.
You know, it's just, I mean, they do a lot of edits and stuff, but... Nah.
I told him to embrace it.
He takes care of himself, too. Like, he don't drink, he don't do anything. He's had a hard life, too. I know that for a fact that he had a hard life. I've heard a lot of his backstory.
So, you obviously didn't start training. There's no official date. It looks like it may be March, it may be... April, but you're ready kicking the gear tomorrow. A lot of meetings, phone calls, promotion, managers, all that.
I mean, it's the weekend.
Oh, all right, Monday.
It's the weekend. We don't know anything. It's the weekend. Everybody enjoying themselves.
O'Hara Davis. Interesting.
Rough night for him, but it's part of boxing. It happens. Message to your fans?
He didn't believe me when I told him. I saw him the other day and I told him, hey, bro, be careful. This dude can crack. He's like, no, I'm going to knock him out. We'll beat the fuck out of him. I'm like, yeah, but I heard you allergic to punchers. Be careful.
How did you? What happened? What did your dad say?
King. Yo te lo dije aquí mismo.
What's your dad saying, Rolly?
No.
Oh, nothing. Okay. I told him. He looks like a boxer.
Yeah, you should probably cut that.
Hey, you want to call anybody out? Do you want to fight anybody? You want to
me?
Yes.
No, I got 60 year old. I'm too tired.
Hey, you got more power punch, bro, than a lot of new boxers.
I don't
young boxers.
Which old guy you want to fight?
Who?
You.
Which old guy you want to fight? It doesn't bother
you. Nobody.
Hey, Rolly told me you're a very good boxer. Number 3 what? In the Cuba. You.
Yes.
Very good.
178 and lose only 5.
178 and 5?
178.
178 wins and only 5.
167 cows.
What?
167 cows.
Yeah. Power. What?
You knock out cows?
Eh?
What did he say? Did he say cows?
He
have a lot of cows.
Yeah.
All my fights. Knockout. You know what I heard?
Damn near all his fights in the amateurs were by knockout.
Wow. Yeah, I heard he said cow.
He only had 5 losses.
Knockout.
How does
he had 5 losses.
How do you say cow in Spanish?
Knockout.
Knockout, you see?
No.
You said cow.
I got confused.
He said cow.
Yeah, cow. Vaca.
Right?
He said knockout?
No, sound. He said cow.
Cow.
Knockout.
Yeah. So vaca.
Like a vaca.
Cow. But you had a lot of knockouts. That's where Rolly gets his power from. I understand.
Yeah.
So, okay, Rolly. Serious note, really quick. Tell all the fans where to follow you. What could they expect for the next few weeks? And is your phone really blowing up every second? A message? Is it really? Let me look quick.
Yeah, my phone's always blowing up.
Yeah, but this is a whole new level. This is where you're supposed to be, Rolly. You're already, you've been a big time.
Yeah, my phone's always blowing up, though.
So do you want to tell them anything if they're watching?
My fans?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Congratulations, first of all, on 300,000. That's not easy to get to. And your post today got tens of thousands of over 1,000 comments. And what are people saying, really?
Awesome.
Let me tell you something.
Yes.
This one, he was 55 years old.
Who did he knock out?
A heavyweight. But...
Your dad doesn't mess around, huh?
Hey.
Defense, defense. At what age? At what age did he come to America? What age did you? ¿Cómo se años when you come to America? How old were you?
30.
So why didn't you box here?
Yeah, because I got some pro.
You had some pro?
Yeah, broken kilo, broken
rib. Oh, broken. Yeah. He had a lot of over 185 fights, mostly wins by knockout.
I'm gonna break one another. You're not.
Rolly, you don't think you get enough credit for your defense?
Coach me, Ali.
Who's the A side? Who's the B side? You and Ryan. Who's the favorite? Like in the casino?
I'm the champion.
You think the Javio is the favorite? Will you be the favorite in a casino, or is it 50-50? What do you think?
I hope I'm under so I can make a fuck ton of money.
I think you're gonna make a lot of money regardless if you ask me, because it's such a big fight.
We shall see.
But congratulations. I really thought you were gonna get the fight personally, because the way it started, he called you out, and then he and Devin started talking, and then now it's you and him. So
patience is everything.
There you have it. And how do you like being here tonight at the Golden Boy event?
It was great. I had a great time.
You get a lot of love. Who'd you sit with? Like any famous people?
I'll sit with Oscar. I was behind Oscar.
What was he talking to you at all?
I gave Bernard Hopkins and Oscar a rose each.
And what did they say?
No, they're just happy with it.
Shout out to both of them. Did you talk to them at all about the fight at all, or like
not yet? We didn't talk about anything.
All right, stay tuned right here. Let me take a picture of you three really quick. Stay tuned. Elisek back reporting.